Hello, good morning. Welcome back to my YouTube channel again. This is Mr. Santos Capellan Jr. Always wishing you a good day. Guys, today what I'm going to show you is my initial setup for a project, okay? I'm going to do a project, a robot project, okay? That is capable of displaying its speed. Let's say if this robot is running, how many... what is the speed? I mean, okay? Now, to be able to know the speed of your robot, first you need to measure the RPM of your DC motor. Okay, I have here my robot chassis. Okay, this is a two-wheel drive robot. Okay, I have here two DC motor. Then, as I said, to measure the RPM of your DC motor, you need one speed sensor here. Okay? So the speed sensor looks something like this, okay? So let me show you. Okay, I have here my DC motor. Now I have here this round thing. This is the one that will give the RPM of the DC motor through the use also of this speed sensor, okay? So if you know the RPM, okay, then the RPM can be converted to KPH, okay? Kilometer per hour, okay? So that's the way you can display the speed of the motor. Of course, you can also, if you know the motor and if you know the diameter of the wheel, you can also display the distance, and or you can also display the angle if your motor is trying to move at the left or right. Okay, so that will be the final outcome of this project. Okay, but today what I'm going to show you is just an initial setup for this robot, because I need to find a way how I'm going to fit all this thing in my small robot. Okay, now actually in this initial setup I'm using this Arduino UNO board, okay, but since the size is a little bit big for this small robot, now I'm planning to use I've just ordered this Arduino Nano, okay? So I'm going to use this Arduino Nano for the final output, okay? So let me put it aside first. Now what are the components? Okay, one microcontroller, at the moment I'm using this UNO, okay? Then one L298N DC motor driver, okay? So this L298 DC motor driver can drive two wheels, okay? So that's why I'm going to use it here, okay? Now, I need also power supply to power up my microcontroller and the DC motor driver, and of course, my the DC motor and the Arduino, and also my LCD display. Now, I'm planning to use an LCD display so that it will display the speed and the RPM of the motor, okay? So this is my initial setup. Now actually, there are so many tutorials in the internet available. Okay, you can go, you can visit the site of Arduino. Then there are a bunch of sample wherein you can measure the RPM of a DC motor. Okay, so I tried to browse some of the examples, then tried to make the sketch program for this initial setup based on those examples. Okay, credit to those people. Okay, now I already uploaded the program. Okay, I tried to write, modify it, and try to upload it here. Okay, now I'm ready to show you how these things work. Okay, so let me power up my system. Okay, let me just power up. Okay, now motor speed. Okay, so let me just focus to here. Okay, so that is my motor speed. Okay. Excuse me. Okay. Now it's already showing the speed of the motor or the RPM, and it is being converted to speed, KPH. Okay. Now as you can see also, my robot. Okay. So it's already working here. By the way, guys, I'm using... Excuse me. Okay. By the way, guys, I'm using a joystick to increase the RPM of the motor, okay? So by playing the joystick, I will be able to change the RPM, okay? Now, okay, let me focus here so that you will be able to see the RPM. Okay, so that is the RPM. Now let me play with the joystick. Okay, so let me increase. Okay, as you can see there, okay, sorry, I need to, okay, I hope you will be able to read, okay, that is the RPM of the motor, okay, then it will is being converted to KPH, okay, I hope you can see the display. Now, sorry for the, because I'm using this, what you call this, module with blue background, okay, so it's not very friendly in displaying the character, especially if it is color white. Okay, now anyway, that is the output of the sketch program when the motor is running or the RPM is being converted to KPH. Okay, that is the purpose of the sketch program. Measure the RPM of the DC motor, then convert it to KPH. Okay, now as you can see, it's working fine. Now my last task is to how I'm going to fit all this microcontroller and the module in a small. Okay, so I'm changing now the speed of the motor. As you can see there, go up to around 500 RPM. Okay, then it's being converted to KPH. Okay. Okay, guys, this is the initial setup for motor vehicle speed monitoring system. Okay, now I will try to upload the final output of this project wherein I can give you a better demo. But for the time being, this will be my initial setup for this project. So, once again, this is Santos Capilan Jr. will always say, let's all be safe. God bless us all. And before I forget, if you are new to my channel, please help me promote my channel by subscribing. You can like and put some comments on this video. Then you can always share it to your friends who are planning to do the same system, because you can use this as an embedded system in your motor vehicle so that you will be able to monitor. But of course, vehicle now, they have their own speedometer. Okay, now this one is just a prototype on how you are going to make an embedded system that will try to, maybe you can also add something here that it will try to give you an alarm, or it will try to notify the driver you are exceeding the speed limit, then you can try to slow down. Okay, so guys, again, as I said, this is just an initial setup. Then if you will be planning to do the same project, then you can always ask me, you can message me, then maybe I can help you. How are you going to do it? Thank you very much, and Santos will end the tutorial or the video by saying God bless us all, and let's all be safe again. Bye for now.